meu convidado é o Gavin Eccles, é o diretor comercial para a Source Airlines, SATA, como é mais conhecida aqui também no Canadá. Bem-vindo ao programa Gente Nossa.
Muito obrigado.
Não sei se disse o título correto.
Sim.
Está correto.
Ótimo. Obrigado, ótimo.
Vamos lá, em primeiro lugar, é natural da Inglaterra.
É verdade, sim.
Mas vive em Portugal, não é?
Mais ou menos 10 anos, em Lisboa.
O seu português já está...
Difícil. Difícil.
Difícil.
Compreendo, num momento difícil todo o dia, na palavra...
Sim. Qual é exatamente a descrição da sua posição na SATA? Quais as suas responsabilidades?
Sim, if I drop into English a little bit, I was brought in mainly to head up the commercial area. So that we start from the planning of routes, network, and then revenue, pricing, sales, marketing, and product experience. So. Mm-hmm. My area is everything really that's not operational.
Of course,
the core focus is the right flights, and then of course the right prices, the right communication and promotion.
Mm-hmm. What are the right flights, by the way?
I think if I take Canada as a route, I think what we know here is that the Toronto flight, we have three flights a week now in the winter, and we take that up to five flights a week during the summer. That for us is a very, very important route, and of course we're feeding people on then to Lisbon and Porto. The other routes that make sense for us very much is the Boston route. That goes up to nine flights a week during the peak summer. And then of course mainland Portugal, where we're talking three flights a day on Lisbon and a daily flight, and then the four other gateways to say the Santa Maria, Pico and Fiel. So that's kind of our main network.
Sim. E a SATA tem assim tantos aviões para cobrir esses voos todas as semanas?
Theoretically what we have in different to the routes, as we say, out of Canada. Here we're talking three flights a week now in the winter, just under 1,000 seats.
E qual é o avião que é usado aqui?
Here we use what we call the A330, so it's around 280 seats. Mm-hmm. 24 seats in business class and the remaining in economy. That's coming in during the whole of the year. We now, as you may have been reading, and there is a new set of operations of the group. We acquired two, what we call A321, two Airbus A321 NEOs. We will have the first operation of a Portuguese airline. This is a what we call a narrow body. So we're going to a single aisle plane. That gives us a lot more opportunities to be more fuel efficient, etc. That will start on Boston. The vision
shortly.
It's just being certified now by ANAC, the Portuguese authority, and that will then start flying into Ponte Delgada to Boston. Mm-hmm. The theory then is that we will run these two A321s for a period of 1.5 years, and then we'll replace those with the A321 long range. That allows us then to look for extending routes, and certainly in Canada, might the opportunity to go back again and look at the direct operations, the non-stop operations to Lisbon and Porto.
Uhum. So, neste momento, de Toronto, temos voos para Ponta Delgada e para o Porto.
How it works is that what we can say is that the three flights in the winter, so this is running now through to the end of March, those three flights all touch Ponta Delgada. Two of those are what we call tagged to Porto. So that means that the customer here in Toronto has one ticket, their luggage is taken all the way through to final destination. When they check in at the airport of Pearson, it will say Porto. Mm-hmm. And they have a stop in Ponta Delgada of around 1 hour. So it's from the agency's point of view, it's a direct flight. But in terms of the consumer, it's what we call direct, but not non-stop.
Mm-hmm, right.
And that's something that we're now exploring for the summer 18. And then in the summer, we take an extra flight from here, Toronto, to Terceira. So that makes up the five. Four flights Ponta Delgada, one flight to Terceira.
E de Montreal também vai haver voo? Existe voo neste momento?
Yeah, Montreal is a seasonal flight, June, from June into September.
Sim, sim.
This year we will operate it with our own aircraft, and we'll operate it with the brand new, it will take the A321. Oh. So the new plane that we're using to Boston, mm-hmm. we are going to put onto the Montreal flight. So the Montreal customers will get the first opportunity also to use a brand new aircraft. And it'll work quite well. So mm-hmm. we complementing Montreal with the A330 coming out of Toronto.
Nos últimos anos, em particularmente 2016 e 2017, houve muitos cancelamentos de voos e muitos atrasos nos voos, que o consumidor, o cliente, obviamente tem que reclamar dessa realidade. Como é que podem explicar alguns desses atrasos e serem tão frequentes?
I think 17. I've only joined the company since May, so I can only really talk on what I've seen since I've been in. Yes, certainly summer 17, we have had some operational difficulties. Mm-hmm. I think it's important that we learn from that. We were trying to increase the schedule from Boston. Was quite strong. We wanted to really make a big push to be able to serve the Massachusetts community, plus the American community, and operationally there was the strikes, which unfortunately we couldn't control, and then we had some incidents with our aircraft. Right. Putting all together, we didn't do as well as operation as we should have done, and I think mm-hmm. it's important that we learn from that. We have to realize that, you know, for customers it's very important, reliability, consistency. You know, the airline is 75 years old. We've had a bad summer. I think it, as long as we learn from that and move forward, I think we what we're now trying to do, and one of the reasons I'm here, is to talk with the travel agents, understand how is it looking for the summer 18, and show a little bit about what we're doing, and mm-hmm. let's try to put behind what happened. Let's right. Kind of move forward, but not forget what happened, because mm-hmm. I think it's very important that we've seen to take our customer experience very important. Since I've joined, I'm now trying to develop a customer experience team that is trying to find out what should be our SATA project, mm-hmm. what it is to fly SATA, what Azores Airlines. Mm-hmm.
So, há uma grande diferença entre a SATA e Azores Airlines?
In terms of the way we work, the Azores Airlines is what we talk about when we think of international.
Right.
So, and it's Toronto, Boston, Montreal, etc., mm-hmm. and then Frankfurt from Germany, London, and the domestic Portugal market. They fly under the brand Azores Airlines, where we have the A321, the A320, and as we move the A321, we'll take out the A310 planes. Mm-hmm. SATA Air Azores is our inter-island airline,
right.
obviously headquartered in Ponta Delgada as the hub. There we have the two planes, the Bombardier Q200, the Bombardier Q400, 37 and 80 seats. Of course, very much integrated into Azores Airlines, because the movement of our passengers from the international or the domestic mainland then is connecting people on mm-hmm. to the situation with the inter-island. So two separate units, but very much coming under the SATA group. Mm-hmm.
Horizonte e António Botelho são proativos com a sua saúde. Praticante de medicina naturopática, utiliza remédios naturais, tratamentos não invasivos e ajuda o seu corpo a restaurar-se.
Quando trata da sua saúde, naturalmente vai ter uma vida mais produtiva e feliz.
Visite Novo Horizonte. Consulte o naturopático António Botelho, 999 Bloor Street West.